A group of people from the Bani Buqayr came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they said, "O Messenger of Allah, marry our daughter to somebody." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "What about Bilal?" And then they came again, and they said, "Marry our daughter to somebody." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "What about Bilal?" And upon the third occasion, they came again, and they said, "O Messenger of Allah, marry our daughter to somebody." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "What about Bilal? A man of Jannah. A man of Jannah." In another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al Jannatu mushtaqun ila Bilal." Jannah longs for Bilal. We long for Jannah, and Jannah longs for Bilal. Upon occasion, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam finished the Fajr Salah, and he turned around and he said, "Oh Bilal, what is it? What action do you do? That last night I entered into Jannah and I heard your footsteps in front of me. What action do you do?" And Bilal radiallahu anhu said, "The only action that comes to my mind is that whenever my wudu breaks, I do my wudu again. And I pray 2 rakats. This was a man who was persecuted for deen. The most severe persecution. He did jihad. He was the muadhin of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But why were his footsteps in Jannah? Because every time his wudu broke, he did wudu. And he prayed 2 rakats. And this is why sometimes we think actions as insignificant, but they are very important. Because they are the foundations. Your salah is your connection with Allah. There was never any sahabi who did not pray their salah. The truth is, when they prayed their salah, they were connected with Allah. They reached their state of ihsan. Bilal on the day of judgment will be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Bilal, he said, "Bilal, live in poverty, remain in the company of poor people and die in poverty." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said regarding himself, "Allahumma ahyini miskinan wa amitni miskinan wa ahshurni fi zumrat al-masakin yawm al-qiyamah." He said, "Oh Allah, as long as you keep me alive, then keep me alive in the state of poverty. Keep me alive in the state of poverty." And this is why when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was passing away, the narration mentioned he only had 7 dirhams in his possession. And he said to Aisha radiallahu anha, he said, "Oh Aisha, give those 7 dirhams in the path of Allah." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam became unconscious, and Aisha radiallahu anha was attending to the Messenger of Allah. And the Messenger of Allah gained consciousness, and he said, "Oh Aisha, have you given those 7 dirhams in the path of Allah?" And she said, "Oh Messenger of Allah, I was busy attending to you." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Oh Aisha, what will I do on the day of judgment? That I will stand in front of Allah and I will have wealth in my possession, only 7 dirhams. Allahumma ahyini miskinan wa amitni miskinan. Oh Allah, when I leave this dunya, take me away from this dunya in a state of poverty." The narration mentioned when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, Aisha radiallahu anha mentions that we didn't even have oil to burn in the lantern of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Not even oil to burn. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said something amazing. He said, "Oh Allah, when you take me into account on the day of judgment, then take me account with the poor people." And he told Bilal, he said, "Bilal, die with the poor people." And the narrations mention that Bilal died in relative poverty. Why? Because he will be in the group of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, ma lana rabbun siwa.